Now let's talk about people and our behavior. Races and nationalities don't exist up there because they're relatively new. I mean, we can even get to, like, say, mixed kids, for example. That has always been around, like the book that you showed. I haven't read it yet, but I'm sure that some of what I'm talking about is in there, maybe, if it's a spiritual book. But anyways, certain races haven't been around forever, right? They had come up out of other races, right? And the further you go from the source, the less you are like the original source. Different things like identity that we attach to don't exist anywhere else except but in our heads, right? I'm a this and I'm a that, and I identify with this and that. That's not real. It feels good. It sounds good to the ego. I get it, but it doesn't exist. Now, if we go up into that unmanifest realm, there is an archetype of people who do exist. And there's a whole plethora of people within that archetype who exist, but only because that archetype exists. What do they say the human race comes out of? They always say, oh, the first bones we found was this black woman in Africa. All the human race comes out of this woman in Africa. That's the tree. That's the tree. It all connects to that primordial source. Now, am I saying someone is better than somebody else? Absolutely not. But what I am saying is that practices like meditation, specifically like taught with Shuddhi, allow you to dissolve the gross elements so that you can see past Maya and see the source that you do come from. And the purification of taught with Shuddhi isn't just that you're imagining shapes. It's that you're spending time with Shiva. You're spending time with that unmanifest. You're spending time with the causal realm, and that connects you back to your soul. So it doesn't matter what race you are, what color you are. If you go through these practices and connect with source, you become one with it.
Yeah, I think I just want to, I'm going to have to get going. But I want to add on to that just a bit, because as part of that, yeah, there's only one race, and that's the human race.
Right.
The perception that we have, what takes us away from the source, is the cultural aspect, is the archetype for which you identify with. So then your matter starts to resonate on that archetype that you build for yourself. When you take it back to the source by going to the primordial source and recognizing your own internal waters, the real self-recognition, do you become like the original archetype? And that has nothing to do with color. It never did. Never. It had everything to do with identification of self. When you identify with yourself as an implant, or as something that is separate from the source, that's when you start to identify with something else and you move further away, just as Trav is saying. Mm-hmm. So that's the real key to seeing through all of this illusion. It had never anything to do with this. There are always going to be new evolutes of the body, right? There's always going to be new evolutes.
Right.
That's never been the issue. The issue has always been that cultural identification. And even culture itself, it's what? When we break down what culture means, that is, how do you identify as an individual? Do you identify as an individual, or do you recognize that you're a part of the source, that you are the source itself? Do you know how to recognize yourself?